The annual Australia-United Kingdom ministerial meeting took place on February 1st and 2nd, in which the two countries made a joint statement stressing the importance of peace and stability across the Taiwan Strait.
The Ministry of National Defense tracked 14 Chinese military aircrafts in the southwest sector of Taiwan's air defense identification zone and four naval vessels around the island on February 2nd. Meanwhile, senior officials from Australia and the UK met in London and Portsmouth for the yearly AUKUS meeting to tackle challenges in the Indo-Pacific region. In a joint statement issued on the 2nd, the Australian and UK ministers again highlighted the importance of peace and stability across the Taiwan Strait, and particularly this year, announced their shared opposition to unilateral changes to the status quo. Both countries would work on deepening relationships with Taiwan and offer support.
That human rights is being threatened by a range of characters around the world, and indeed people are testing sovereignty of nation states in a way that should worry us all. And whether you are in Ukraine or whether you are in the far Pacific, from a United Kingdom's point of view, those values are true and are worth standing up for.
The United Kingdom and the United States working together with us through the architecture of AUKUS to help Australia acquire a nuclear-powered submarine capability.
UK and Australia stressed their strong opposition to China's increasing military presence in the South China Sea. Officials also took the opportunity to visit the Australian Armed Forces, which are providing training for Ukrainian volunteer corps in the UK to help them defend their country. Meanwhile, Japanese Foreign Minister Yoshimasa Hayashi expressed Japan's serious concerns over China's military actions in the East China Sea and military coordination with Russia over the phone with Chinese Foreign Minister Qin Gang. Hayashi also stressed the importance of maintaining peace and stability across the Taiwan Strait. U.S. Secretary of State Antony J. Blinken will head to Beijing for the first time on the 5th. There is a chance he will be meeting with Chinese President Xi Jinping. Nine Republican senators wrote a letter to Blinken to remind him that U.S. President Biden has made a promise to Taiwan and that he should abide by the Taiwan Travel Act. They also urged Blinken to tell the Chinese leadership that their military aggression is unacceptable.